Welcome to another edition of Fashion Counsel. Today we're being joined by Mike Stevens again. Mike speaks to us on many of the issues of HR and employment in the fashion realm.
Hey, Tony.
So today we're going to speak about interns. And we have a lot of clients that really rely on interns. And in fact, the interns absolutely want to work for the fashion companies to get some experience. But there have been a number of lawsuits recently tied up with the hiring of interns. Can you maybe give us some background on that?
Sure. Ever since April 2010, the Department of Labor has been carefully scrutinizing unpaid internship programs. They've been a staple in the fashion industry. A lot of fashion houses use them. It's a good source of finding potential employment. So it is a staple in the fashion industry, as I said, but it has come under increasing scrutiny by the Department of Labor. In April of 2010, they issued a fact sheet which put together a test for whether an unpaid intern is really an unpaid intern or an employee. As a result of that fact sheet, a lot of employees or interns have sued big fashion houses seeking back wages. So Alexander McQueen and Donna Karan and Norma Kamali have all been sued on a class action basis. There have been settlements that have been in the hundreds of thousands of dollars, so it's a real big issue for the industry.
So Mike, you said that there's a determination whether they're an intern or an employee. So I guess if they're an employee, they have to pay all the benefits and everything else, but if they're an intern, they don't? Is that what that means?
Yeah, so the test that the Department of Labor has established looks at six factors. The first factor, and probably the most important, is that the program has to be educational or academic in nature. It's great if the intern gets academic credit for the program, but the fashion house should also build in some academic component of the program, like lectures or training materials, things like that.
So learning about the industry, learning how the fashion houses work, learning about how they sell, things like that, that would all be beneficial.
That's all important, but it's also important to give them skills that they can apply outside the fashion industry or to other employers. So there has to be some sort of academic component. Lectures, course materials. It doesn't have to happen all the time, but it has to be a part of the program. Secondly, the intern cannot displace regular employees. If the intern is doing work of other employees, they're going to be found to be an employee too.
So if they're licking stamps and doing envelopes, that's okay?
Right.
Okay.
Third, the internship has to benefit the intern, not the company. By benefiting the intern, I mean they're getting academic credit or they're getting job skills that they can apply in a variety of different settings. Next, the fashion company cannot get any direct benefit from the work of the intern. In fact, their operations should be impeded to some extent because they're spending time supervising the intern. And then finally, it's very important that there's a clear understanding between the intern and the fashion company that the intern won't get paid for his work.
You have fashion clients that clearly want to continue having internship programs and not paying. How would you advise them? What can they do?
Well, there's no way of avoiding risk completely, but if you want to have an unpaid internship program, the way to do it is to take that Department of Labor fact sheet and build an internship program around it. Make sure all of those factors exist in your program. Sign an internship agreement with the intern that acknowledges that all of those factors are present and acknowledges that the intern doesn't expect to get paid for his or her work. If you're uncomfortable with taking risk and you don't want to be the subject of a possible class action lawsuit, the easiest thing to do is just pay your interns minimum wage for each hour that they work and try to monitor the hours that they work so that you don't get exposed to overtime compensation.
Would you say that the most important factor here is getting school credit?
Getting school credit is very important. It goes a long way to establishing an unpaid internship program.
That's great advice, Mike. Thanks.
My pleasure.
So fashion houses that want to continue to have unpaid internship programs really need to think through these issues before they bring the interns in to avoid class action lawsuits. Once again, Mike, thanks for the great advice.
Thank you, Tony.